Hi, I'm Patu from FreeFinCal. Today, let's talk about a question I received and a question many young people ask. SIP or lump sum, which is a better way to invest in mutual funds? Now, this question is a wrong question. And if you're asking a wrong question, you will never find the right answer. I think what people usually mean is that they have a lump sum and they want to know whether they want to invest that money in one shot or they should invest that money over the course of a few months, which is some people call it a systematic transfer plan, or you can just manually invest every week or every month or so. It doesn't matter. So that is a lump sum versus STP or a gradual investment question. So the answer to that question I have already discussed in a video, and I've done a back test for different STP periods, and I've shown that sometimes lump sum works, sometimes gradually investing over the course of a few months works. You don't know that beforehand. So just that, if you have a lump sum, first of all, you should know what a lump sum is. Lump sum is a money that is much bigger than your the usual money that you invest every month at the very least. So if that is the case, then you gradually invest it over the next few weeks or the next few months so that you minimize regret. Because if you put that money and the market falls, then you will feel that you made a mistake. So just to minimize those kind of possibilities, you can gradually spread out that, stagger that investment, spread it out and so on. Just for psychological comfort. So that question is different. Now, this question makes no sense, because if you are going to, let's say, start an SIP for 10 years, there's no point asking whether a 10-year SIP return will be better than a 10-year lump sum return, because the total amount of money that you will be investing over the next 10 years, you obviously don't have it as a lump sum today. If you already have it as a lump sum, then you have to gradually spread it out over the next 1 year or over the next 12 months or 24 months. Nobody's going to, somebody has a lump sum, nobody's going to spread it over the next 10 years. That's just meaningless, right? So this question is more of an academic question. People have done research on this, whether dollar cost averaging or rupee cost averaging is better than one shot investing and so on. That's an academic question. It's not a practical question that investors should be asking. Of course, you can show data, but nobody is going to say, okay, I'm just going to invest one time in my life. Nobody's ever going to do that, right? Over a 10-year period, for example, even if you don't do an SIP, you're obviously going to invest more than once. You're obviously going to invest at least once a year or every few years, every few quarters, something like that. So that's also a kind of SIP only. So everybody is going to do SIPs only in life. That is what I'm trying to say is, everybody's return will be an XIRR calculation. It will not be a CAGR calculation. When you do a lump sum, you're going to do a CAGR, compounded annualized growth rate calculation. But when you're doing multiple investments over every month, every week, once a year, once a quarter, whatever the frequency, it will be an XIRR calculation. XIRR basically means that it is some kind of average of individual CAGR. Every investment that you make will grow at some kind of annualized rate, and you are basically taking some kind of average that will fit for the entire investment, and that's called the XIRR. So everybody's realistic portfolio will have some kind of XIRR value only and not a CAGR. So this question itself is wrong. You have to frame the question, first of all, better. Anyway, for what it's worth, I'll show you an astounding graph. I was really surprised about it. But first, let's look at 10-year. This is the 10-year SIP returns. Let me probably make this a little smaller. My chair is creaking. I'm sorry. This is 10-year SIP returns on the y-axis versus the 10-year lump sum CAGR returns. Both the x and y-axis are having the same graduation, so you can, it's an equal kind of comparison. You can see that these numbers on the y-axis, the dots are a little bit higher for over 10 years. But anyway, if the 10-year CAGR is high, the 10-year XIRR will be high. So the 10-year lump sum return is high means the XIRR will automatically be high. There's some kind of approximate linear correlation between the two. And then again, for 5 years, you can see a little bit higher return for SIP over 5 years and than the lump sum, because of the way in which you can see this. You get 30 here itself at 20. So that means the SIP returns are a little bit higher. Does it mean SIP is better than lump sum? No, I mean, that makes no sense. Because it's not going to be practically possible, because you can't say I will just wait for 5 years and then collect money and then put it as lump sum, or nobody's going to have whatever money they're going to invest over 5 years as a lump sum today. So it's a meaningless statistic, and this is only over the last 5 years. If you do a rolling return analysis, this is the graph I'm just telling you, I didn't expect this much difference. I have never compared these two, to be frank. Although I had these tools for years now, this is the 10-year rolling SIP data for Nifty 50 total return. So every dot is a 10-year SIP return, and then every blue dot, every orange dot is a 10-year lump sum return, and approximately the periods are the same, except for a few days here or there. There'll be a small difference in the from date and the to date, but other than that, it's matching very closely. But look at the difference. There's a huge difference. I didn't expect this at all. I checked the data once or twice to make sure this is correct, but I think it's correct. And you can see now that the lump sum has got very high difference compared to the SIP returns. So what does it mean? You'll do lump sum, is it? It makes no sense. The question itself makes no sense. Even academically, it makes no sense in my question, in my opinion. Practically, as an investor, it makes zero sense. So let's not ask wrong questions. Bye-bye.